with us. Are you surprised by the 7-point spread?
I'm not surprised. you know, if Dallas was facing a team who thought run first, I'd be like, hey, this Dallas defense, they're built to stop that run, or they've been doing that, you know, mm-hmm. pretty well. Maybe 7's a little high, but, you know, this Rams team is, yeah, they have Todd Gurley, and he's going to run the ball, but they want to throw the ball. Let's be real. They want to throw the ball.
And they want to throw it downfield.
Yes, yes. And Dallas, I like Byron Jones. I think he's a heck of a player, but I can't name too many other guys.
Awuzie is playing at a high level. I got to tell you.
He is, but would you like him to cover Brandon Cooks all over the field?
I don't
Robert Woods?
I don't mind. Well, he's going to have to do one or the other.
Yeah, he's going to have to cover one.
Yeah.
And so, to me, I just think this Rams offense is going to be just a little bit too explosive. They're going to get the ball out of Jared Goff's hands initially to try to stop that pass rush. They are great at running screens, misdirections. I just think the offense is going to be a little bit too much for this Dallas defense. And we already know that Dallas's offense is kind of handicapped a little bit to where Dak, even though he's getting better, and even though I like Dak, I just think the pressure they'll apply.
That hurt handicap. Mm.
So they should park in the handicap spot.
They are going to take Ezekiel Elliott away. They have to. And when they do that, the ball's in Dak hands. You got Aaron Donald.
The Angels ain't handicapped. So you know, like the jersey, like if you won Walter Payton Man of the Year, you got that little stick logo on there. Yeah. They say he got a handicap stick on his jersey.
Really?
Yeah, that was.
So when the team bus pulls up in the parking lot, it deserves to take all the handicaps.
No, just that. No.
That was D Hall say. I don't know anything about that. You know what?
I'm saying they got limitations.
I want you to go skip.
Limitations.
How nice of you.
I want you to.
I got to write this down. Hold on. Limitations and handicaps.
I love it, Skip.
You know, this point spread, which is shocking to me. I always try to guess them, and I thought maybe 3.5, 4, but to go all the way to 7, I think it would have been even higher than that. It's just another sign of the disrespect that was heaped on this football team all year long. And I will be the first to admit, some of the disrespect was deserved because it was self-inflicted. Okay. I'm going to say again what I've been saying about this team all year long. In all my years of rooting for teams in lots of sports, mm-hmm. I've never been more frustrated by a team I've rooted for than this year's Dallas Cowboys, because even in the same game, they can flash, to me, greatness, mm-hmm. and then they'll flash badness. And it goes even in
greatness?
The second. Yeah, greatness.
Really good,
second,
maybe.
Second Philly game at Jerry World. They flashed greatness in the fourth quarter because my quarterback, I don't know how he did this because he can't throw. He's inaccurate. He threw for 243 yards. No, is that right? 243.
17 to 20. I'm sorry.
It's 243. Just in the fourth quarter and overtime, he went 17.
Why was the game that close?
For 243. I got to process that. 240. He can't throw and he's inaccurate, but 243
yards.
See, that's flashing greatness to me.
Okay.
And he is a warrior winner. And I can just show you play after play that he makes, but you look at him and say, yeah, but he's not that. He's not that. Sometimes he does it different ways.
I mean, the same reason some people love Cam Newton and some mm-hmm. people hate
okay.
Cam Newton.
All right.
Is yes, you're absolutely right. Okay. Dak can do it
in a lot of different ways. To use the oldest cliche in sports, this team has shown you again and again at every turn that its glass is half full. Because you can say it's half empty. You see it half empty. You see it
full. No, you said three quarters full the way you be talking.
It's not that I see it half empty. Mm-hmm. I see it half full. Mm-hmm. I just see the Rams and that team as three quarters full. Mm. And so to me, I'm going with the winner. Mm. I'm going with the winner. I'm not saying Dallas is trash and they're bum. I'm saying, yes, they do have some limitations.
He said they're not trash and bums. He said they're one or the other.
I think I'd be lying to myself if I came here and didn't say that.
Yeah, he'd be lying, Skip. Mm.
That Dak is not a guy that I want throwing the ball 30 to 40 times in a football game.
If he has to, they're going to lose.
And I think that's what they're going to try to make
them do. That's not the formula. That's not the recipe.
But if I'm
the Dallas Cowboys are an underrated physical football team.
Yeah,
they can manhandle you in both sides of the ball at the line of scrimmage. They can wear you down and wear you out. And the Rams, in the end, are more of a finesse offense than a physical offense.
And that's what scares me, Skip. Mm-hmm. I will admit that you are absolutely right. That's what was shocking when Dallas got blown out in Indianapolis is because they didn't look like the tougher football
team. They did
not. And previous to that, they had.
Mm-hmm.
And so Like, I tell people all the time, people love football because you can't measure a man's heart, right? He can run this fast, he can do that, but it don't matter. If this dude on this team hits him in the mouth and he can't take it...
That's the essence of
that. That's the neutralizer.
That's it.
And so if Dallas hits these guys in the mouth, I don't know.
And my quarterback will hit you in the mouth. It's why when Zeke was asked by Aaron Andrews to talk about what this guy just did, he just shrugged and said, he's a grown-ass man. And what he meant was... He's just a physical football player. Give him the football, and he'll figure out how to beat you with this football. He'll throw it, or he'll run it right down your throat.
That's what I'm saying.
And he ran it.
He's hard to tackle.
He's hard to tackle.
Skip, you know what? I don't normally do this, but I'm going to agree with you, Skip Bayless. I think this line is too high for the simple fact this is not a normal home field. This is not Arrowhead. This is not Foxborough. Because guess what?
You're right.
60%. Of the people in the Coliseum will be Cowboy fans.
I'm pretty sure.
You're right.
So you're right. The normal 3 points that you would get for having a legit home field, okay, that's out the window. So I think a touchdown is a little bit too high.
Okay.
The thing that concerns me about the Rams offense is really a play action 5-7 step because they're trying to get the ball down the field. They're not dinking and dunking. They're not throwing no flat routes and no slants. They're throwing deep comebacks. They're throwing dagger routes. They're throwing deep over routes. They're throwing posts. They're throwing shake routes. So in order for you to do that, you have to go back a little further. And in the process of going back, you let the Dallas Cowboys line get closer to you. So I definitely think this is far, far too high. It doesn't mean I think the Cowboys are going to win because I think the Rams are going to win. And I'm looking. I need them corners. I need Peters. Peters, play your game. You're not a press corner. You're an off corner. He like to sit back there, see that thing develop. Oh, y'all are a 2-by-1. I see this on 2nd and 8. Y'all like to run. I'm going to jump in. I tell you what, if you run that tight end on this Yogi route, I'm going to pick it.
Okay.
Go get him.
So I don't know how this happened, but that Ram defense that I thought was going to be spectacularly shut down good, allowed the 20th most points in the NFL. I don't get it.
It's been average.
And 3 weeks ago, on the same day, it was the night of that debacle at Indianapolis, that 23-0 goose egg that my team laid. Somehow, the Philadelphia Eagles went right here to this stadium here, not too far from this studio, and beat that team, 30-23. Nick Foles beat Jared Goff, right? And that was a turning point for Philadelphia because they took off from
that game. But you said Foles better than Dak. That's what you say.
I didn't say he's better than Dak.
Whoa, talk about he won a Super Bowl. He outgunned Tom Brady. Can Dak outgun Tom Brady? I want to hear you say it.
He outgunned Bill Belichick.
No.
Am I right?
No, you're wrong.
He hung 41 on Bill Belichick.
Outgunned Tom.
We're talking about the Cowboys because I was trying to make the point that the Eagles beat the Rams and the Cowboys had already beaten the Eagles twice.
Oh, so you see, hey, that's how we grew up.
He beat them, so we can beat him too.
You can do that with aberration games, fluky games, but wait a second. Dallas had already beaten the Eagles twice. Does that count? Did you do that when you were little kids? You weren't able to say twice, right?
Not twice. Skip.
I want some doing this game and the Chargers game.
So I get to 7.
Right? No, Skip, stop it. As a matter of fact, you know what I want, Skip? I do sweet tea now. I need you to go to Chick-fil-A and get me a gallon of sweet tea.
Sweet tea?
Sweet tea!
You don't want to drink sweet tea.
Yeah, that's terrible for you. Enough for you.
I know it's you're not talking about healthy, Jimmy.
I'm not betting.
You don't drink sweet tea.
I want sweet tea. A gallon.
Lord have mercy.
Or you get me.
I will not do that.
Okay, how about this here? Will you buy me 2 shots of McCallum 1824?
Yeah. That's what you
want.
Because you may need.
Oh, that old 1937 or 1990. That's what
this
I like.
It's going to be an expensive year for you guys.
I know is my
Come
team
on,
is,
Rams.
My team is very capable of controlling the football
the
clock. My defense is capable of rising and shining when you least expect it. You say, how did they do that to Drew Brees? I don't know how they did that to Drew Brees.
Anything can happen any one given game. Day, any game, any play.
But my team has won 8 or 9 games, and it's still a 7-point underdog? I don't know how that happened.
You do, though. And you say you like Vegas. Vegas knows what they're doing. That's what you tell me all the time.
except when it comes to this team.
No, that they don't know.
I think it's helping them, though, that everyone is
too.
kind of looking the other way.
I love it that D-Hall doubts the Dallas Cowboys. That's the headline takeaway from what we just discussed.
Skip
doubts the Cowboys.
That got a stick on his jersey.
They've got
love
the momentum.
It.
That got a stick on his jersey.
I can't wait to see you again, then, Skip.
I can't
wait. That silhouette in the rolling chair.
Here we go.
That wheelchair, that with that.
D'Angelo,
who thought they could beat the Seahawks? Nobody,
man,
especially you.
I picked them to beat the Seahawks. Yes, I did.
Oh, I didn't hear
because that try to smash my football. That played right into their hands.
Wait a second. The Hall of Famer did not pick them. How do you explain that?
You know, this is how it works. I don't know if anybody knows it, but Jenny, you're married. See, okay, let's just say for the sake of argument, you're engaged to get married, and someone calls the wedding off, say, a year into, you know, we're supposed to get engaged, or 6 months. Which hurts worse, Jenny, calling the wedding off a year or 6 months, or showing up at the altar and he don't show up?
Number two.
Your point is... The farther you go, the more it's going to hurt you, Skip Bayless. I didn't want the wild card. It doesn't hurt. Ooh, the farther you go along, because then you think, we one step away from the Super Bowl. We one step away.
Wait, I heard the same argument last week. You said it's going to hurt more because it's a playoff game. And Dallas doesn't win playoff games.
Think about it.
Really? How